Once upon a time, on a planet not so far away, small cells changed the face of dust into life. Now, these small cells were microscopic lives, microorganisms, also called microbes, evolving on our planet Earth billions of years ago. Fast forward now to 2023, they are still around. Do you see them? Look at me. Who do you see? Look to your right. Look to your left. The other right. What do you see? Humans, perhaps person. Now, if we could look closer through a lens that zoomed over 1,000 times, we would begin to see the invisible yet living realities. Microbes, bacteria, fungi, yeasts. Now, to me, as a researcher, studying microbes and what they can do has opened my eyes. So I take this opportunity this evening to share with you how knowing microbes can help us see life better. Because you see, you and I are full of them. In our own bodies, these microbial cells outnumber our own human cells. Right here, right now, they are on us, within us, around us. The air you are breathing, the water you're drinking, the food you just had. They're on the carpet I'm standing, on the chairs you're seated, in the cars you drove, in the car park, in the soil. A handful of soil can have more microbes than all of humans on this planet. Billions, trillions, nonillions are like a normal calculations in the microbial world. They are all around us. How do they survive? They can eat almost anything, bread, crude oil, metals. They can live inside rocks or salt crystals. And some of them do like extreme conditions, no stress. Be it boiling waters, hot springs, to the ice-cold waters of the Antarctic, from our rainforests to deserts, from very high altitudes to deep sea levels, you will see microbes everywhere. But do you see them? Is seeing really believing? Or is it knowing something? Well, we've seen microbes in bad light as bugs, as germs, as parasites, rotting our stuff. They spoil our food, they make us sick. And with the recent happenings around the globe reminding us of the warning of the legendary Louis Pasteur that microbes will have the last word. And we are left to wonder if the last of us will be a fungus or a virus. Hope not. Now, if microbes can break us, they can also make us. Think about it. More than double the number of our own human cells are microbial cells. So that means millions of microbial genes drive us as compared to our own 20,000 odd human genes. When you and I were born, not so long ago, our mothers not just gave us good genes, they did give us a beautiful set of microbes. Through the process of birth, through breastfeeding, through nurture, those microbes were crucial for our survival. There's more reasons to be grateful now to our mothers, isn't it? So these microbes colonize our skin, they are present in the mouth, in our intestines, protecting us. protecting our skin, digesting our food, making our vitamins? Or do you believe in gut feeling? Yes? Probably you've got good microbes in your gut that breaks down your food and keeps you in good mood and good health. Speaking of food, who makes it? What makes it? Say, yogurt in Greece, sauerkraut in Germany, idli or dosa in India, tapai in Brunei, tofu in China, miso in Japan, kimchi in Korea, bread, cheese, yogurt, pickles, you name it. Microbes make it. They make our food, they sustain us, and they run this world. They drive cycles, you see, of carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, making these nutrients available for plants to grow. The plants grow and produce food. Plants and animals are sustained by microbes. Plants and animals die. That's now not how it should end, though, because after everything dies, what happens? Microbes are at work, right? Degrading the dead matter, bringing nutrients back to soil, and using the same nutrients for new plants to grow. So there you go. Microbes assist in creation. They sustain life throughout. They transform dead matter back to the soil, bringing life a full circle. That's how cyclical the impact of these invisible organisms are. My team and I have been exploring microorganisms in this land of hidden treasures, and they have revealed us several insights, which I would like to show you to help us see them better through five keywords. One, synergy. Two, simple. Three, small. Four, speed. Five, sustainability. Let's begin with synergy. Microbes always are partnering with something, with other microbes, with humans, with animals, with plants. So if you want to study them, you don't have to look too far, isn't it? You have the forests, the mangroves, the coastal areas that are a niche of different microbes, incredible ones here in Brunei. And when you bring them to the laboratory, you understand that they are very simple, as seen under the microscope on the right-hand side, the other right. Single cells, simple, capable of performing complex functions and sustaining themselves. So simplicity is the key, so they can be used as miniature factories and can be used as models. Third keyword, small. Microbe literally means small life. It's viewed under a microscope, measured in a micron, and hence the name, which is 1/1,000,000th of a meter. So if you take an average human female height, 1.6 meters, you would need 1.6 million bacteria stacked end to end to reach that height. No wonder we can't see them. Just imagine, what if we could see at the micro scale, nano scale, viruses, bacteria around us? Would our outlook or view and assumptions of this world still be the same? I feel small. The power of a microbe. This is the bacteria in a magnified image. Coming to point number four is the power of a microbe. It lies in its speed. Typically, bacteria grow every 20 minutes. By the end of about 8 hours, you have billions and billions of microbial cells. As a child, I would be fascinated. You would have seen in your houses too. How my grandma just puts a drop of yogurt in a pan of warm milk, and within a few hours, a firmly set yogurt is ready. Who made it? So now I know it's lactobacillus converting lactose sugar into lactic acid and all the microbial processes that is happening. So because of the speed at which the microbes grow, they can be grown and segregated as fungus, as bacteria, as actinomycetes, as algae, yeasts, okay? And they can be separated and cataloged together from oil zones, forests, or mangroves that we have isolated them, make a collection for use in certain applications, which brings me to my final point, sustainability. Yes, the role of infinitely small is indeed infinitely great. Microbes sustain this planet very well because they bring about a balance. A microbial imbalance in our body causes diseases. A microbial imbalance on the planet causes pollution. So in our research, we have been asking a few questions to which the microbes we are studying are offering potential solutions, such as, can we degrade crude oil? The bacteria we isolated from oil zones in Brunei, when optimized, can produce surfactants that can degrade oil, which could be of use in tackling oil spills. Can we clear turbid water? Microbes like Pseudomonas, isolated from coastal areas, produce flocculants that aggregate and precipitate suspended particles can be used to clarify water, perhaps useful in water treatment plants. Clean water is one of the goals of sustainable development. Can we detoxify dyes? This is a rainforest. You would have invariably seen fungus growing on dead wood. If it was not for fungus and its enzymes, we would all be neck deep in garbage, right? So that those enzymes are highly efficient and can degrade similar toxic chemicals like dyes, which can be used in effluent treatments, sewage treatments. How about plastics? When we grew bacteria isolated from crude oil on plastic as the sole source of carbon, they grew slowly and steadily, indicating of a machinery that they could eat up plastic. This is a developing science, and if this could be developed, perhaps would aid in addressing the plastic menace that we have created. Can we reduce the use of synthetic pesticides, fertilizers, chemicals? Trichoderma, the fungus isolated from mangroves, was able to keep a check against rhizoctonia, which causes sheath blight, a disease in paddy. So yes, it has the potential to be developed as a biofertilizer or biopesticide, for example, because the impetus on agricultural productivity has to maintain a balance with indiscriminate use of any fertilizers. Finally, how about any new molecules, therapeutic compounds with medicinal properties? I would say Brunei is a niche because there's a lot of untapped resource, and some of the microbes that we have studied from mangroves are giving hit samples, and if the therapeutic properties could be explored, that would be useful in pharmaceutical sciences. Just a few examples to show you how these simple, single-celled invisible beings, through synergy and speed, could result in an impact that's so incredible, very much visible, and sustainable. Microbes sustain this planet. They have been here billions of years ago. They are here, right now. They make us. Just think, I mean, if I'm made of such innumerable, invisible, diverse, living realities, then who am I? Life is so much more than meets the eye. And to know that impact, you need to take a closer look, right? Look to your right. Look to your left. Look at me. Now, what do you see?